modernity and social changes in the Europe. So this is your first topic in sociology optional one. Hello friends, today we'll have a discussion on modernity and social changes in the Europe. So this is your first topic in sociology optional one. And we always get question from this topic. You can see here, there are many questions UPSC always like, you know, they ask. Now, one of the questions which is really very important to know, because it is telling everything about how modernity has emerged in Europe and how it led to the development of sociology. So this question like this, discuss the historical antecedents of the emergence of sociology as a discipline. So in 2019, this question was being asked. On similar aspect, again, we did have a question on 2020. How did the intellectual forces lead to the emergence of sociology? What aspects of enlightenment do you think paved way for the emergence of sociology? Elaborate. This question was in 2022. Okay. Now, to answer this question, I think that the knowledge of history is really important. You can only build up your understanding on sociology if you, from the beginning, has this understanding, clear understanding, that sociology is highly interrelated discipline. To know what is happening in today's society, you need to have good understanding what had happened in the past. In fact, there are many sociologists who say that there is no differences in sociology and history. History is the study of the past society and sociology is the history of present society. That is why you see that not many questions are coming from this particular topic into on the subtopic of historical events. And one of the questions is directly asking historical antecedents. So modernity, we may find, or today we are living in a postmodern time, but it has its roots in the past. Okay, so let's see what type of clarity you should have to understand what is modernity and how and when we found a new discipline called sociology. What was the requirement? Please have this clarity that sociology is a critical discipline. It is very much interested to know how we analyze and understand our present society. It definitely helps you to become a deep thinker. If you have studied sociology earlier, or if you are studying sociology, and if you just can understand this particular point, that whatever you see in today's time around you, it might be a part of your common sensical understanding. You must have understand history, okay? But that is, in history, that is about the events in a chronological manner that you have to learn, maybe the facts, the dates. But when you are discussing about all this past phenomenon, you need to understand in cause and effect relationship. What happened in the past? What were the causes to occur that? And what changes it inflicted on society? That is how you need to understand history. Don't get confused that when I'm going to tell you about the world history, don't think that it is a world history topic. You just need to have little understanding that, okay, what had happened, what was the period of time, but you need to talk about modernity, okay? And that too in 150 words. So it really requires lot of practices and clarity. So as I have said that to understand about modernity and social changes, you need to know what had happened in the world history. So I'm just going to give you a little understanding on the world history. I'm not teaching world history, it's just I'm teaching you the facts, you know, what we have found. We know that all major civilizations of world prospered near river valley, and we know the reasons because of transportation, agriculture, and we did have civilization called Egyptians, Mesopotamian and Indus Valley civilization, right? So this is what you can see here. We did have four river valley civilization, right? So this is, you can see the China one here, this is Harappa, and then you can talk about here, right? Ancient and Indus Valley. So all these were there initially. So you should just understand what had happened and all that. Now, what was there after civilization, what had happened? The world history. We know that Roman Empire was the largest ruling kingdom, and during this time, it was, you know, it spread across Europe, Africa, and Asia. And then some of the details you should be knowing, what was happening, Abbasid Caliphate and the mighty Safavid dynasty was ruling in the Middle East, and other people who were just ruling over there. You just have little understanding that, okay, what was our world? What kind of political or economical situation was there? Majorly political situation. How this world and the society started transforming, okay? So this is what you should be knowing. So we can see that it was mighty Ottoman Empire replaced Romans. Now Romans were replaced by Ottoman Empire as rulers of the three continents, and China was ruled by Manchurian Empire. Mughals established All India Empire. All right, so this is we can see here. And this is what we see today. So we do have 195 countries, 193 of them members of United Nations. Okay, so these are our current map. Now, to understand how modernity have come, how capitalism have come, how society rapidly got changed, we must know about the period from 9th to 12th century, basically from Dark Ages, Renaissance till Industrial Revolution. That is something as a sociologist or as a student of sociology we are interested in. But then you need to know what had happened in the past, okay? So you will see an empire across three continents. We will see it was Greco-Roman Empire, strongest in ancient time, started to decline after 5th century, right? And you will see that how Europe was divided into more than 500 feudal states. So what is something which you have to understand about feudalism? Okay? So Greco-Roman Empire and how they have declined, how reason was the feudalism. This is something we will focus on. And just for understanding, you should know what was happening in India. So Chalukyas were fighting with Imperial Cholas in South and Gujarat, Prithviraj and all that. It was happening in North India during this phase. Okay. Now we will talk about the dark phases, but we'll see what is feudalism. Now in feudalism, you will see that there was, at that point of time, there was no powerful state. There was no state army, no money economy, no market. So it was a time in which the power of kings were not that huge, were not that dominant. Okay, so it was definitely, we'll talk about the hierarchy. So kings, nobles, knights and the peasants. Now you will see that the feudal lords used to maintain army for the protection of their land. And whensoever the king used to fight, they used to take help of feudal lords because they used to take the army. And this is how feudalism got very dominant factor during that point of time. So you will see from 14th to 15th century onwards and before that, what was happening? There was a kind of, again, anarchy or chaos, it is referred as dark ages. Okay, it is referred as dark ages because, you know, we didn't know what is happening, how, what we have to do, like, you know, as a structure, as a social order, the society was disturbed. Now, in 14th century Europe, it was marked by lot many disasters, natural disasters, economical disasters, political disasters, that was actually happening. So rulers started looking for different ways to captivate situations, and slowly and gradually, by the time 14th century have come up, feudalism also, you can say, were on the edge of collapsing. So it was now declining. So feudalism was also a kind of declining, you will see. But by the 14th century itself, you will see that philosophers were started asking that what should be the structure of a society. Okay, so definitely feudalism was there, but it was also having some sort of issues, problems. I mean, see, trading was the main important factor by the time it had happened. Okay, and there were lot many issues and the problems society were facing. So that point of time, intellectuals, UPSC did ask also question very, like, you know, several times, how intellectual ideas paved for the emergence of sociology. Now, during 14th century or during Renaissance phase, the intellectuals started questioning and wanted to know or explore that what should be the solutions to this problem. So what they have done, they started looking back in their past, in their history. In this, they have started highlighting that what their earlier people or the ancestor have contributed. So they started reviving their past. Okay, so they started reviving their past by reading different classical texts, art, literature, and finally they concluded that it should be humanistic values which should govern the society. It should not be power or religion which has no scientific tempo. So Renaissance philosophers definitely put lot of importance on having reasons, but at that point of time they were not radical, they were soft, romantic, like you will see how Leonardo da Vinci is making the pictures and explaining that how, you know, we should have a secular idea, and there are lot many philosophers. Okay, so what you will see, Renaissance is a rebirth of a culture, art, writing, music, reformation was happening. They started talking about the Christian dominance, enlightenment, scientific revolutions, all this were happening, you know. So you did have Herodotus, you did have Pythagoras, you did have, you know, the writings of Aristotle and Socrates, Plato. These were the people. So that Renaissance was a time of philosophers. Okay, now after Renaissance, you will see that the later second phase we can talk about as Enlightenment. Now during this phase, during Enlightenment, what was happening? During Enlightenment, people become, philosophers become radical. They have started saying, and it is a period of 16th to 17th century. Now the philosophers have started contributing and writing that it should be science and reasons and nothing else should govern the society. During Renaissance phase, people were exploring. But during after this Enlightenment phase, people have got enriched ideas, like we have Locke, Hobbes, who are talking about social contract theory, we have Montesquieu, you know, so we did have philosophers who were talking about human rights. Okay, they are talking about that how individuals, humans, doesn't matter in which class he or she, like, you know, born into, they have some rights. This led to further political revolutions, like American Revolution, French Revolutions. So these all are the historical evidence, right? And then we know about Industrial Revolution. All these phases are historical. and this gradually led to the changes in society. Now, during Industrial Revolution, during 18th, 19th century, what had happened? Industrial Revolution and colonization. Now, this was a period when sociology emerged. We did have American Revolution, we did have French Revolution, right? Lot many things were happening here. People have started talking about liberty, fraternity, equality, and Industrial Revolution were just bringing a rapid changes in the structures of society. Now, at this stage, you know, during mid 18th century, society was completely in chaos. It was not at all that earlier changes were not there, but the changes were gradual. But because of scientific discoveries and because of, you know, enhanced rapid developments in communication and technologies, the changes which were coming, it was very speedy in pace. And everything was changing. Very first time, world witnessed something called slum developments. Migration started happening. People have started leaving their families into villages and then working in the factories in town. And lot many health diseases. So poverty become a major problem. And lot many other problems. Now all these forced intellectuals of modern phase, you will say. Modernity, you can say, is generally we understand by various concepts, but modernity we talk about. So it was a period by 18th to 19th century in sociology we understand, for the sake of understanding. Modernity has a lot of discussion. It's a phases, right? It's a new development. Now, all these changes led thinkers to believe that we need a discipline which can talk about practical issues of humans, which can also critically understand what had happened, which will not take anything as it is given to them. They will question it and try to analyze society with scientific temper. This actually was the major reason people thought, philosopher thought, that we do have to develop our discipline, right? So during 17th century, Auguste Comte, Saint Simon, and then you know that how Karl Marx writing has a major influences in sociology, Emil Durkheim. We do have George, like, you know, many thinkers, George Simmel. All these thinkers are trying to understand what we can contribute by creating a new discipline, which other previously existing discipline could not do, such as philosophy, history, or any other discipline. Okay? So sociology did emerge because of all these historical factors which I just discussed. Okay? So for this particular topic, you have seen that how UPSC lot many time ask questions, and which is just talking about that how intellectual ideas, okay, have led to the development of sociology, like how has Enlightenment contribute to the emergence of sociology. And they are asking again, how did the emergence of industrial society change the family in Western Europe? So lot many time UPSC did ask question on this. Okay, so I like to conclude. For your topic one, you must have understanding of world history, what had happened in the past. But then you need to understand all those factors which is actually responsible for the development of sociology as a discipline, such as Renaissance, Enlightenment, revolutions like French Revolution in particular, and then Industrial Revolution. So if you're writing on these events, then I think you are writing on the demand of the question which is being asked, and I believe that you'll get the good marks. Thank you.